Hi guys, welcome to part four. Before we get started in the raw sessions, which I'm sure you are excited about, I just want to explain a couple things and a couple ways that raw talks in the sessions. Now the first one he uses, and I'm just going to say he because it's easier, he uses the term social memory complex. So this simply stated is basically what consciousness is. Our consciousness, his consciousness, and the unified consciousness, the social memory complex. And he also uses the term mind-body-spirit complex, which basically just means us, you know, humans, our bodies, who we are right now in third density reality. You have to remember that Ra is a six-dimensional being that can take on different shapes. Like at times they can be just pure energy, pure consciousness. He has obviously iterated to our planet as Ra in the Egyptian times, which he does go into depth with in these first couple sessions. And he's also, say, been like an alien on a different planet. So because Ra has been so many different forms, the way he projects and explains us and talks about us, he calls us the mind-body-spirit complex, which actually I find kind of funny. And one of the things that they don't really make clear is that we have on this 3D reality planet, we have free will, and no being in any other dimension or anywhere is allowed to interfere with our free will. So comes up every now and then how Ra is not really allowed to give up anything without us asking for it. You know, the questions have to be asked. They can't. Ra is not able just to tell us what to ask for. And that doesn't get made very clear, but that does go on in these first few sessions. And a lot of these first few sessions are really about the instrument, which is the person, Carla, who is being the channeler in these sessions, and how they can maximize her as a clear channel. So they went through a lot of processes, all the things that she wears, the things that are in the room. And one of the things was this chalice of water. Now, if you have ever gone online and looked at Dr. Emoto's work about positively charged, loved water, like if you love a glass of water and put the words love to it and say loving things to it and then drink it, it does change the composition of that water. And that has been proven over and over again. And this was in, you know, these recordings were in the 80s, the early 80s, before any of that work got published. But yet it was used during these sessions, which I find interesting that they knew about it then when we didn't get to know about it until, you know, a decade later. So that part is interesting. So they do talk a little bit about that water and everything that they need in the energies of the earth and the positioning of her body and the incense. Everything is to make a very clear channel for Ra. So these sessions are a lot of fun. The reason I am putting these online the way I am is that you can actually go online and listen to these live sessions. They were all recorded and they're all online. The problem is it's extremely slow. Ra is talking through another person, so it's like one painstaking word at a time to make it very clear. So it takes a long time. And if you're like me, when you're on to something and you want the knowledge, you don't want to drink from an eyedropper, you want to drink from a fire hose. So that's why I have put this video together the way it is, because we can get through the material quite quickly, because I like to listen to it over and over and over again, because I get something just a little bit different every time I listen to it. And so even just this last time I listened to it about the structure and how the pyramids were built and what they were for, I got a better and better understanding of it. And I'll do more narrative talks about things like this in later videos, but I really just want to get these online so you guys can start listening to it and understanding it, and we can have better commentary in the comments about it. So let's just get right into it. Here is part four, starting with session one with Ra.
The Law of One, Book I, Session 1, January 15, 1981. Ra, I am Ra. I have not spoken through this instrument before. We had to wait until she was precisely tuned, as we send a narrow band vibration. We greet you in the love and in the light of our infinite creator. We have watched your group. We have been called to your group, for you have a need for the diversity of experiences and channeling which go with a more intensive, or as you might call it, advanced approach to the system of studying the pattern of the illusions of your body, your mind, and your spirit, which you call seeking the truth. We hope to offer you a somewhat different slant upon the information which is always and ever the same. At this time we would be glad to attempt to speak to any subject or question which those entities in the room may have potential use in the requesting. Questioner, do you have a specific purpose, and if so, could you tell us something of what your purpose is? Ra, I am Ra. We communicate now. We are those who are of the Law of One. In our vibration the polarities are harmonized, the complexities are simplified, the paradoxes have a solution. We are one. That is our nature and our purpose. We are old upon your planet and have served with varying degrees of success in transmitting the Law of One, of unity, of singleness to your peoples. We have walked your planet. We have seen the faces of your peoples. However, we now feel the great responsibility of staying in the capacity of removing the distortions and powers that have been given to the Law of One. We will continue in this, until, shall we say, your cycle is appropriately ended. If not this one, then the next. We are not a part of time and, thus, are able to be with you in any of your times. Does this give you enough information from which to extract our purpose, my brother? Questioner, yes. Thank you. Ra, I am Ra. We appreciate your vibrations. Is there another query? Questioner, I've heard of the name Ra in connection with the Egyptians. Are you connected with that Ra in any way? Ra, I am Ra. Yes, the connection is congruency. May we elucidate? What do you not understand? Questioner, could you give me a little more detail about your role with the Egyptians? Ra, I am Ra. The identity of the vibration Ra is our identity. We as a group, or what you would call a social memory complex, made contact with a race of your planetary kind which you call Egyptians. Others from our density made contact at the same time in South America, and the so-called lost cities were their attempts to contribute to the Law of One. We spoke to one who heard and understood and was in a position to decree the Law of One. However, the priests and peoples of that era quickly distorted our message, robbing it of the, shall we say, compassion with which unity is informed by its very nature. Since it contains all, it cannot abhor any. When we were no longer able to have appropriate channels through which to enunciate the Law of One, we removed ourselves from the now hypocritical position which we had allowed ourselves to be placed in. Other myths, shall we say, having more to do with polarity and the things of your vibration that are complex, again took over in that particular society complex. Does this form a sufficient amount of information, or could we speak further? Is there another query? Questioner, the question was lost because the questioner was sitting too far from the tape recorder to be recorded. Ra, I am Ra. Consider, if you will, that the universe is infinite. This has yet to be proven or disproven, but we can assure you that there is no end to yourselves, your understanding, what you would call your journey of seeking, or your perceptions of the creation. That which is infinite cannot be many, for manyness is a finite concept. To have infinity you must identify or define the infinity as unity, otherwise, the term does not have any referent or meaning. In an infinite creator there is only unity. You have seen simple examples of unity. You have seen the prism which shows all colors stemming from the sunlight. This is a simplistic example of unity. In truth there is no right or wrong. There is no polarity, for all will be, as you would say, reconciled at some point in your dance through the mind-body-spirit complex which you amuse yourself by distorting in various ways at this time. This distortion is not in any case necessary. It is chosen by each of you as an alternative to understanding the complete unity of thought which binds all things. You are not speaking of similar or somewhat like entities or things. You are everything, Every being, every emotion, every event, every situation. You are unity. You are infinity. You are love light, light love. You are. This is the law of one. May we enunciate in more detail? Questioner, no. Ra, I am Ra. Is there another query at this time? Questioner, can you comment on the coming planetary changes in our physical reality? Ra, I am Ra. I preferred to wait till this instrument had again reached a proper state of depth of singleness or one-pointedness before we spoke. The changes are very, very trivial. We do not concern ourselves with the conditions which bring about harvest. Questioner, if an individual makes efforts to act as a catalyst in general to increase the awareness of planetary consciousness, is he of any aid in that direction, or is he doing nothing but acting upon himself? Ra, I am Ra. We shall answer your question in two parts, both of which are important equally. Firstly, you must understand that the distinction between yourself and others is not visible to us. We do not consider that a separation exists between the consciousness-raising efforts of the distortion which you project as a personality and the distortion that you project as another personality. Thus, to learn is the same as to teach unless you are not teaching what you are learning, in which case you have done you them little good. This understanding should be pondered by your mind-body-spirit complex as it is a distortion which plays a part in your experiences at this nexus. To turn to the second part of our response, may we state our understanding, limited though it is. Group individuated consciousness is that state of sharing understanding with the other distortions of mind-body-spirit complexes, which are within the evident reach of the mind-body-spirit complex individual or group. Thus, we are speaking to you in accepting both our distortions and your own in order to enunciate the laws of creation, more especially the law of one. We are not available to many of your peoples, for this is not an easily understood way of communication or type of philosophy. However, our very being is hopefully a poignant example of both the necessity and the near hopelessness of attempting to teach. Each of those in this group is striving to use, digest, and diversify the information which we are sending this instrument into the channels of the mind-body-spirit complex without distortion. The few whom you will illuminate by sharing your light are far more than enough reason for the greatest possible effort. To serve one is to serve all. Therefore, we offer the question back to you to state that indeed it is the only activity worth doing. To learn, teach, or teach learn. There is nothing else which is of aid in demonstrating the original thought except your very being, and the distortions that come from the unexplained, inarticulate, or mystery-clad being are many. Thus, to attempt to discern and weave your way through as many group mind-body-spirit distortions as possible among your peoples in the course of your teaching is a very good effort to make. We can speak no more valiantly of your desire to serve. May we speak in any other capacity upon this subject? Questioner, will you be available for communication? Can we call on you in the future? Ra, I am Ra. We have good contact with this instrument because of her recent experiences with trance. She is to be able to communicate our thoughts in your future. However, we advise care in disturbing the channel for a few moments and then the proper procedure for aiding an instrument who has, to some extent, the need of re-entering the mind-body-spirit complex which the instrument has chosen for the life experience of this time-space. Do you understand how to nurture this instrument? Questioner, no. Could you explain it? Ra, we suggest first a brief period of silence. Then the repetition of the instrument's vibratory complex of sound in your density which you call name. Repeat until an answer is obtained. Then the laying on of the hands at the neck region for a brief period so that the instrument may recharge batteries which are not, shall we say, full of the essence of this particular field at this time. And finally, a gift of water into which the love of all present has been given. This will restore this entity, for her distortions contain great sensitivity towards the vibrations of love and the charged water will affect comfort. Do you now understand? Questioner, not completely. Ra, I am Ra. We search your mind to find the vibration, nickname. It is this vibration from you which contains the largest amount of what you would call love. Others would call this entity, first name. The charging of the water is done by those present placing their hands over the glass and visualizing the power of love entering the water. This will charge that very effective medium with those vibrations. This instrument is, at this time, quite fatigued. However, her heart is such that she continues to remain open to us and useful as a channel. This is why we have spent the time-space explaining how the distortions of what you may call fatigue may be ameliorated. Under no circumstances should this instrument be touched until she has responded to her name. I do not wish to take this instrument beyond her capacity for physical energy. It grows low. Therefore, I must leave this instrument. I leave you in the glory and peace of unity. Go forth in peace, rejoicing in the power of the one Creator. Session 2. January 20th, 1981. Ra, I am Ra. I greet you in the loving the light of our infinite Creator. I am with this mind-body-spirit complex which has offered itself for a channel. I communicate with you. Queries are in order in your projections of mind distortion at this time-space. Thusly would I assure this group that my own social memory complex has one particular method of communicating with those few who may be able to harmonize their distortions with ours, and that is to respond to queries for information. We are comfortable with this format. May the queries now begin. Questioner, I'm guessing that there are enough people who would understand what you are saying, who would be interested enough in it, for us to make a book of your communications, and I wondered if you would agree to this. If so, I was thinking that possibly a bit of historical background of yourself might be in order. Ra, I am Ra. The possibility of communication, as you would call it, from the one to the one, through distortion, acceptable for meaning is the reason we contacted this group. There are few who will grasp, without significant distortion, that which we communicate through this connection with this mind-body-spirit complex. However, if it be your desire to share our communications with others, we have a distortion towards a perception that this would be most helpful in regularizing and crystallizing your own patterns of vibration upon the levels of experience which you call the life. If one is illuminated, are not all illuminated? Therefore, we are oriented towards speaking for you in whatever supply of speakingness you may desire. To teach learn is the law of one in one of its most elementary distortions. Questioner, could you tell us something of your historical background and your contact with earlier races on this planet? Then we would have something to start with. Ra, I am Ra. We are aware that your mind-body is calculating the proper method of performing the task of creating a teach-learning instrument. We are aware that you find our incarnate, as you call it, state of interest. We waited for a second query so as to emphasize that the time-space of several thousand of your years creates a spurious type of interest. Thus in giving this information, we ask the proper lack of stress be placed upon our experiences in your local space-time. The teach-learning which is our responsibility is philosophical rather than historical. We shall proceed with your request which is harmless if properly evaluated. We are those of the Confederation who 11,000 of your years ago came to two of your planetary cultures which were at that time closely in touch with the creation of the One Creator. It was our naive belief that we could teach learn by direct contact and that the free will distortions of individual feeling or personality were in no danger. We had no thought of their being disturbed, as these cultures were already closely aligned with an all-embracing belief in the liveness or consciousness of all. We came and were welcomed by the peoples whom we wished to serve. We attempted to aid them in technical ways having to do with the healing of mind-body-spirit complex distortions through the use of the crystal, appropriate to the distortion. Placed within a certain appropriate series of ratios of time-space material. Thus were the pyramids created. We found that the technology was reserved largely for those with the effectual mind-body distortion of power. This was not intended by the Law of One. We left your peoples. The group that was to work with those in the area of South America, as you call that portion of your sphere, gave up not so easily. They returned. We did not. However, we have never left your vibration due to our responsibility for the changes in consciousness we had first caused and then found distorted in ways not relegated to the Law of One. We attempted to contact the rulers of the land to which we had come, that land which you call Egypt, or in some areas, the Holy Land. In the 18th dynasty, as it is known in your records of space-time distortions, we were able to contact a pharaoh, as you would call him. The man was small in life experience on your plane and was a what this instrument would call, wanderer. Thus, this mind-body-spirit complex received our communication distortions and was able to blend his distortions with our own. This young entity had been given a vibratory complex of sound which vibrated in honor of the prosperous god, as this mind-body complex, which we call instrument for convenience, would call Ammon. The entity decided that this name, being in honor of one among many gods, was not acceptable for inclusion in his vibratory sound complex. Thus, he changed his name to one which honored the sun disk. This distortion, called Aten, was a close distortion to our reality as we understand our own nature of mind-body-spirit complex distortion. However, it does not come totally into alignment with the intended teach-learning which was sent. This entity, Ikhnaten, became convinced that the vibration of one was the true spiritual vibration and thus decreed the Law of One. However, this entity's beliefs were accepted by very few. his priests gave lip service only, without the spiritual distortion towards seeking. The peoples continued in their beliefs. When this entity was no longer in this density, again the polarized beliefs in the many gods came into their own and continued so until the one known as Muhammad delivered the peoples into a more intelligible distortion of mind-body-spirit relationships. Do you have a more detailed interest at this time? Questioner, we are very interested in the entire story that you have to tell and getting into the Law of One in quite some detail. There will be several questions that I'll ask as we go along that may or may not be related directly to understanding the Law of One. However, I believe that the proper way of presenting this as a teach-learning vehicle is to investigate different facets of what you tell us. You spoke of crystal healing. One other thing I want to mention is that when the instrument becomes fatigued, we want to cut off communication and continue questions at a later time when the instrument is recharged. If the instrument is suitable at this time, we would like a little information about the crystal healing that you mentioned. Ra, I am Ra. The principle of crystal healing is based upon an understanding of the hierarchical nature of the structure of the illusion, which is the physical body, as you would call it. There are crystals which work upon the energies coming into the spiritual body, there are crystals which work upon the distortions from spirit to mind, there are crystals which balance the distortions between the mind and the body. All of these crystal healings are charged through purified channels. Without the relative crystallization of the healer working with the crystal will not be properly charged. The other ingredient is the proper alignment with the energy fields of the planet upon which you dwell and the holistic or cosmic distortions or streamings which enter the planetary aura in such a manner that an appropriate ratio of shapes and placement within these shapes is of indicated aid in the untangling or balancing process. To go through the various crystals to be used would be exhaustive to this instrument, although you may ask us if you wish in another session. The delicacy, shall we say, of the choosing of the crystal is very critical and, in truth, a crystalline structure such as a diamond or ruby can be used by a purified channel who is filled with the love light of one, in almost any application. This, of course, takes initiation, and there never have been many to persevere to the extent of progressing through the various distortion leavings which initiation causes. May we further inform you in any fairly brief way upon this or another subject? Questioner, yes. You mentioned that the pyramids were an outgrowth of this. Could you expand a little on that? Were you responsible for the building of the pyramid, and what was the purpose of the pyramid? Ra, I am Ra. The larger pyramids were built by our ability using the forces of one. The stones are alive. It has not been so understood by the mind-body-spirit distortions of your culture. The purposes of the pyramids were two. Firstly, to have a properly oriented place of initiation for those who wish to become purified or initiated channels for the Law of One. Two, we wish then to carefully guide the initiates in developing a healing of the people whom they sought to aid, and of the planet itself. Pyramid after pyramid charged by the crystal and initiate were designed to balance the incoming energy of the one creation with the many and multiple distortions of the planetary mind-body-spirit. In this effort we were able to continue work that brothers within the Confederation had effected through building of other crystal-bearing structures and thus complete a ring, if you will, of these about the Earths. As this instrument would have us vibrate it, surface. This instrument begins to lose energy. We ask for one more query or subject and then we shall take our leave for this time space. Questioner, you might mention that originally there was a capstone on the pyramid at the top. What was it made of and how you moved the heavy blocks to build the pyramid? What technique was used for that? Ra, I am Ra. I request that we be asked this question in our next work time, as you would term the distortion sharing that our energies produce. If you have any questions about the proper use of this mind-body-spirit, we would appreciate your asking them now. Questioner, considered them asked. I don't have anything to go on. What is the proper use of this instrument? What should we do? What should we do to maximize her ability and her comfort? Ra, I am Ra. We are pleased that you have asked this question for it is not our understanding that we have the right duty to share our perceptions on any subject but philosophy without direct question. However, this mind-body-spirit is not being correctly used and therefore is experiencing unnecessary distortions of body in the area of fatigue. The vibrations may well be purified by a simple turning to the circle of one in the verbal vibration while doing so of the following dialogue. Question, what is the law? Answer, the law is one. Question, why are we here? Answer, we seek the law of one. Question, why do we seek Ra? Answer, Ra is an humble messenger of the law of one. Both together, rejoice then and purify this place in the Law of One. Let no thought form enter the circle we have walked about this instrument, for the law is one. The instrument at this time should be in trance. The proper alignment is the head pointed 20 degrees north by northeast. This is the direction from which the newer or new age distortions of love light, which are less distorted, are emanating, and this instrument will find comfort therein. This is a sensitive instrument, by which we mean the distortions which enter her mind-body-spirit complex come from any of her senses. Thus, it is well to do the following. Place at the entity's head a virgin chalice of water. To the center, the book most closely aligned with the instrument's mental distortions which are allied most closely with the law of one, that being the Bible that she touches most frequently. To the other side of the Bible, a small amount of sense, or incense, in a virgin censer. To the rear of the book symbolizing one, open to the Gospel of John, chapter 1, a white candle. The instrument would be strengthened by the wearing of a white robe. The instrument shall be covered in prone, the eyes covered. We feel that, though this is a complex of activity circumstance and may seem very distorted from a purposeful teach learning experience. These elaborations on the technique of trance will ease the mind distortions of those about the instrument as they perceive improvement in the instrument's distortions with regard to fatigue. We add only that if these teach learning sessions are held during time space during which your sun buddy does not light your room, that it is best to call the instrument before the lighting of the illuminatory mechanism. I am Ra. I leave you in the glory and the peace of the One Creator. Rejoice in the love light, and go forth in the power of the One Creator. Enjoy, we leave you. Adonai. Session 3. January 21, 1981. Ra, I am Ra. I greet you in love in the light of the one infinite creator. I communicate with you now. Questioner, my first question is, did we correctly perform the ritual for starting the communication? Ra, I am Ra. The placement of the artifacts designated to balance the instrument should be placed at the instrument's head for the least distortion of effect. The remainder of the beginning account of purpose is quite acceptable, for those speaking desire to serve. Otherwise, the attendant emphasis in mind complexities would not have been affected properly. We caution you to guard against those who are not wishing to serve others above all else. From taking part in the beginning or in lending their distortions of mind-body-spirit complex to any session, as we should then be unable to properly blend our distortions with those of this instrument. Questioner, should I move the Bible, candle, and incense at this time? Ra, I am Ra. This would be appropriate. Questioner, after moving the items, is this the proper position? Ra, I am Ra. Please correct the angle of the incense so that it is perpendicular to the plane of 20 degrees north by northeast. Questioner, after making the correction, is this satisfactory? Ra, I am Ra. Please check by eye to make fine correction. We will explain the process by which this becomes a significant distortion balancer. The incense acts as energizer to the physical body of this instrument, signifying its humanity. This is, therefore, a necessity that the wafted smoke is perceived from the same relative angle as the instrument perceives the opened Bible balanced by the lighted candle, signifying love light and light love, and, therefore, give the mental and emotional, shall we call it, distortion complex of this instrument the sight of paradise and peace which it seeks. Thus energized from the lower to the higher, the instrument becomes balanced and does not grow fatigued. We appreciate your concern, for this will enable our teach learning to proceed more easily. Questioner, does everything appear correctly aligned now? Ra, I am Ra. I judge it within limits of acceptability. Questioner, at the last session we had two questions that we were saving for this session, one having to do with the possible capstone on top of the Great Pyramid at Giza. The other having to do with how you moved the heavy blocks that make up the pyramid. I know these questions are of no importance with respect to the Law of One, but it was my judgment, and please correct me if I am wrong, and make the necessary suggestions, that this would provide an easy entry for those who would read the material that will eventually become a book. We are very grateful for your contact and will certainly take any suggestions as to how we should receive this information. Ra, I am Ra. I will not suggest the proper series of questions. This is your prerogative as free agent of the Law of One, having learned understood that our social memory complex cannot effectually discern the distortions of the societal mind-body-spirit complex of your peoples. We wish now to fulfill our teach learning honor responsibility by answering what is asked. This only will suffice, for we cannot plumb the depths of the distortion complexes which infect your peoples. The first question, therefore, is the capstone. We iterate the unimportance of this type of data. The so-called Great Pyramid had two capstones. One was of our design and was of smaller and carefully contrived pieces of the material upon your planet which you call granite. This was contrived for crystalline properties and for the proper flow of your atmosphere by a type of what you would call chimney. At a time when we as a people had left your density, the original was taken away and a more precious one substituted. It consisted, in part, of a golden material. This did not change the properties of the pyramid, as you call it, at all, and was a distortion due to the desire of a few to mandate the use of the structure as a royal place only. Do you wish to query further upon this first question? Questioner, what did you mean by chimney? What was its specific purpose? Ra, I am Ra. There is a proper flow of your atmosphere which, though small, freshens the whole of the structure. This was designed by having airflow ducts, as this instrument might call them, situated so that there was a freshness of atmosphere without any disturbance or draft. Questioner, how were the blocks moved? Ra, I am Ra. You must picture the activity within all that is created. The energy is, though finite, quite large compared to the understanding distortion by your peoples. This is an obvious point well known to your people, but little considered. This energy is intelligent. It is hierarchical. Much as your mind-body-spirit complex dwells within a hierarchy of vehicles and retains, therefore, the shell or shape or field, and the intelligence of each ascendingly intelligent or balanced body, so does each atom of such a material as rock. When one can speak to that intelligence, the finite energy of the physical, or chemical rock body is put into contact with that infinite power which is resident in the more well-tuned bodies, be they human or rock. With this connection made, a request may be given. The intelligence of infinite rockness communicates to its physical vehicle, and that splitting and moving which is desired is then carried out through the displacement of the energy field of rockness from finity to a dimension which we may conveniently call, simply, infinity. In this way, that which is required is accomplished due to a cooperation of the infinite understanding of the Creator indwelling in the living rock. This is, of course, the mechanism by which many things are accomplished, which are not subject to your present means of physical analysis of action at a distance. Questioner, I am reminded of the statement, approximately, that if you had faith to move a mountain, the mountain would move. This seems to be approximately what you were saying. That if you are fully aware of the law of one, you would be able to do these things. Is that correct? Ra, I am Ra. The vibratory distortion of sound, faith, is perhaps one of the stumbling blocks between those of what we may call the infinite path and those of the finite proving understanding. You are precisely correct in your understanding of the congruency of faith and intelligent infinity. However, one is a spiritual term, the other more acceptable perhaps to the conceptual framework distortions of those who seek with measure and pen. Questioner, then if an individual is totally informed with respect to the law of one and lives the law of one, then such things as the building of the pyramids by direct mental effort would be commonplace. Is that what I am to understand? Ra, I am Ra. You are incorrect in that there is a distinction between the individual power through the law of one and the combined, or societal memory complex mind-body-spirit understanding of the law of one. In the first case only the one individual, purified of all flaws, could move a mountain. In the case of mass understanding of unity, each individual may contain an acceptable amount of distortion and yet the mass mind could move mountains. The progress is normally from the understanding which you now seek to a dimension of understanding which is governed by the laws of love, and which seeks the laws of light. Those who are vibrating with the law of light seek the law of one. Those who vibrate with the law of one seek the law of foreverness. We cannot say what is beyond this dissolution of the unified self with all that there is, for we still seek to become all that there is, and still are we Ra. Thus our paths go onward. Questioner, was the pyramid then built by the mutual action of many? Ra, I am Ra. The pyramids which we thought built were constructed thought forms created by our social memory complex. Questioner, then the rock was created in place rather than moved from some place else? Is that correct? Ra, I am Ra. We built with everlasting rock the great pyramid, as you call it. Other of the pyramids were built with stone moved from one place to another. Questioner, what is everlasting rock? Ra, I am Ra. If you can understand the concept of thought forms, you will realize that the thought form is more regular in its distortion than the energy fields created by the materials in the rock which has been created through thought form from thought to finite energy and beingness in your, shall we say, distorted reflection of the level of the thought form. May we answer you in any more helpful way? Questioner, this is rather trivial, but I was wondering why the pyramid was built with many blocks rather than creating the whole thing as one form created at once? Ra, I am Ra. There is a law which we believe to be one of the more significant primal distortions of the Law of One. That is the Law of Confusion. You have called this the Law of Free Will. We wish to make an healing machine, or time-space ratio complex which was as efficacious as possible. However, we did not desire to allow the mystery to be penetrated by the peoples in such a way that we became worshipped as builders of a miraculous pyramid. Thus it appears to be made, not thought. Questioner, well, then you speak of the pyramid, the Great Pyramid, I assume, as primarily a healing machine, and also you spoke of it as a device for initiation. Are these one and the same concept? Ra, I am Ra. They are part of one complex of love, light, and intent sharing. To use the healing properly, it was important to have a purified and dedicated channel, or energizer, for the love light of the infinite creator to flow through. Thus the initiatory method was necessary to prepare the mind, the body, and the spirit for service in the creator's work. The two are integral. Questioner, does the shape of the pyramid have a function in the initiation process? Ra, I am Ra. This is a large question. We feel that we shall begin and ask you to reevaluate and ask further at a later session, this somewhat, shall we say, informative point. To begin, there are two main functions of the pyramid in relation to the initiatory procedures. One has to do with the body. Before the body can be initiated, the mind must be initiated. This is the point at which most adepts of your present cycle find their mind-body-spirit complexes distorted from. When the character and personality that is the true identity of the mind has been discovered, the body then must be known in each and every way. Thus, the various functions of the body need understanding and control with detachment. The first use of the pyramid, then, is the going down into the pyramid for purposes of deprivation of sensory input so that the body may, in a sense, be dead and another life begin. We advise, at this time, any necessary questions and a fairly rapid ending of this session. Have you any query at this time space? Questioner, the only question is there anything that we have done wrong, or that we could do to make the instrument more comfortable? Ra, I am Ra. We scan this instrument. This instrument has been much aided by these precautions. We suggest only some attention to the neck, which seems in this body distortion to be distorted in the area of strength weakness. More support, therefore, to the neck area may be innate. Questioner, should we have the instrument drink the water from the chalice behind her head, or should we have her drink from another glass after we charge it with love? Ra, I am Ra. That and only that chalice shall be the most beneficial, as the virgin material living in the chalice accepts, retains, and responds to the love vibration activated by your beingness. I am Ra. I will now leave this group rejoicing in the power and peace of the One Creator. Adonai. Session 4. January 22, 1981. Ra, I am Ra. I greet you in the love and the light of the infinite creator. I communicate with you now. Questioner, when we finished the last session, I had asked a question that was too long to answer. It had to do with the shape of the pyramid, its relationship to the initiation. Is this the appropriate time to ask this question? Ra, I am Ra. Yes, this is an appropriate time-space to ask that question. Questioner, does the shape of the pyramid have an effect upon the initiation? Ra, I am Ra. As we began the last session question, you have already recorded in your individual memory complex the first use of the shape having to do with the body complex initiation. The initiation of spirit was a more carefully designed type of initiation as regards the time-space ratios about which the entity to be initiated found itself. If you will picture with me the side of the so-called pyramid shape and mentally imagine this triangle cut into four equal triangles, you will find the intersection of the triangle, which is at the first level on each of the four sides, forms a diamond in a plane which is horizontal. The middle of this plane is the appropriate place for the intersection of the energies streaming from the infinite dimensions and the mind-body-spirit complexes of various interwoven energy fields. Thus it was designed that the one to be initiated would, by mind, be able to perceive and then channel this, shall we say, gateway to intelligent infinity. This, then, was the second point of designing this specific shape. May we provide a further description of any kind to your query? Questioner, yes. As I understand it then, the initiate was to be on the center line of that pyramid, but at an altitude above the base as defined by the intersection of the four triangles made by dividing each side. Is that correct? Ra, I am Ra. This is correct. Questioner, then at this point there is a focusing of energy that is extra-dimensional in respect to our dimensions. Am I right? Ra, I am Ra. You may use that vibratory sound complex. However, it is not totally and specifically correct. There are no extra dimensions. We would prefer the use of the term multidimensional. Questioner, is the size of the pyramid a function of the effectiveness of the initiation? Ra, I am Ra. Each size pyramid has its own point of streaming and of intelligent infinity. Thus, a tiny pyramid that can be placed below a body or above a body will have specific and various effects depending upon the placement of the body in relationship to the entrance point of intelligent infinity. For the purposes of initiation, the size needed to be large enough to create the impression of towering size so that the entrance point of multidimensional intelligent infinity would completely pervade and fill the channel. The entire body being able to rest in this focused area. Furthermore, it was necessary for healing purposes that both channel and the one to be healed be able to rest within that focused point. Questioner, is the large pyramid at Giza still usable for this purpose, or is it no longer functional? Ra, I am Ra. That, like many other pyramid structures, is like the piano out of tune. It, as this instrument would express it, plays the tune but, oh, so poorly. The disharmony jangles the sensitivity. Only the ghost of the streaming still remains due to the shifting of the streaming points, which is in turn due to the shifting electromagnetic field of your planet. Due also to the discordant vibratory complexes of those who have used the initiatory and healing place for less compassionate purposes. Questioner, would it be possible to build a pyramid and properly align it and use it today from the materials that we have available? Ra, I am Ra. It is quite possible for you to build a pyramid structure. The material used is not critical, merely the ratios of time-space complexes. However, the use of the structure for initiation and healing depends completely upon the inner disciplines of the channels attempting such work. Questioner, my question then would be, are there individuals incarnate upon the planet today who would have the inner disciplines to, using your instructions, construct and initiate in a pyramid they built? Is this within the limits of what anyone on the planet today can do? Or is there no one available for this? Ra, I am Ra. There are people, as you call them, who are able to take this calling at this nexus. However, we wish to point out once again that the time of the pyramids, as you would call it, is past. It is indeed a timeless structure. However, the streamings from the universe were, at the time we attempted to aid this planet, those which required a certain understanding of purity. This understanding has, as the streamings revolved and all things evolve, changed to a more enlightened view of purity. Thus, there are those among your people at this time whose purity is already one with intelligent infinity. Without the use of structures, healer patient can gain healing. May we further speak to some specific point? Questioner, is it possible for you to instruct in these healing techniques if we could make available an individual who had the native ability? Ra, I am Ra. It is possible. We must add that many systems of teach learning the healing patient nexus are proper given the various mind-body-spirit complexes. We ask your imagination to consider the relative simplicity of the mind in the earlier cycle and the less distorted, but often overly complex, views and thought-spirit processes of the same mind-body-spirit complexes after many incarnations. We also ask your imagination to conceive of those who have chosen the distortion of service and have removed their mind-body-spirit complexes from one dimension to another, thus bringing with them in totally latent form many skills and understandings which more closely match the distortions of the healing patient processes. Questioner, I would very much like to continue investigation into the possibility of this healing process, but I'm a little lost as to where to begin. Can you tell me where my first step would be? Ra, I am Ra. I cannot tell you what to ask. I may suggest that you consider the somewhat complex information just given and thus discover several avenues of inquiry. There is one health, as you call it, in your polarized environment, but there are several significantly various distortions of types of mind-body-spirit complexes. Each type must pursue its own learned teaching in this area. Questioner, would you say, then, that the first step would be to find an individual with ability brought with him into this incarnation? Is this correct? Ra, I am Ra. This is correct. Questioner, once I have selected an individual to perform the healing, it would be helpful to receive instruction from you. Is this possible? Ra, I am Ra. This is possible given the distortions of vibratory sound complexes. Questioner, I'm assuming, then, that the selected individual would be one who is very much in harmony with the Law of One. Even though he may not have any intellectual understanding of it, he should be living the Law of One? Ra, I am Ra. This is both correct and incorrect. The first case, that being correctness, would apply to one such as the questioner himself who has the distortions towards healing, as you call it. The incorrectness which shall be observed is the healing of those whose activities in your space-time illusion do not reflect the law of one, but whose ability has found its pathway to intelligent infinity regardless of the plane of existence from which this distortion is found. Questioner, I'm a little confused. I partially understand you, but I'm not sure that I fully understand you. Could you restate that in another way? Ra, I am Ra. I can restate that in many ways, given this instrument's knowledge of your vibratory sound complexes. I will strive for a shorter distortion at this time. Two kinds there are who can heal, those such as yourself who, having the innate distortion towards knowledge giving of the law of one, can heal but do not, and those who, having the same knowledge, but showing no significant distortions toward the law of one in mind, body, or spirit, yet, and nevertheless, have opened a channel to the same ability. The point being that there are those who, without proper training, shall we say, nevertheless, heal. It is a further item of interest that those whose life does not equal their work may find some difficulty in absorbing the energy of intelligent infinity and thus become quite distorted in such a way as to cause disharmony in themselves and others, and perhaps even find it necessary to cease the healing activity. Therefore, those of the first type, those who seek to serve and are willing to be trained in thought, word, and action are those who will be able to comfortably maintain the distortion towards service in the area of healing. Questioner, then would it be possible for you to train us in healing awareness? Ra, I am Ra. It is possible. Questioner, will you train us? Ra, I am Ra. We will. Questioner, I have no idea how long this would take. Is it possible for you to give a synopsis of the program of training required? I have no knowledge of what questions to ask at this point. Ra, I am Ra. We consider your request for information, for as you noted, there are a significant number of vibratory sound complexes which can be used in sequence to train the healer. The synopsis is a very appropriate entry that you might understand what is involved. Firstly, the mind must be known to itself. This is perhaps the most demanding part of healing work. If the mind knows itself, then the most important aspect of healing has occurred. Consciousness is the microcosm of the law of one. The second part has to do with the disciplines of the body complexes. In the streamings reaching your planet at this time, these understandings and disciplines have to do with the balance between love and wisdom and the use of the body in its natural functions. The third area is the spiritual, and in this area the first two disciplines are connected through the attainment of contact with intelligent infinity. Questioner, I believe I have a little idea of the accomplishment of the first step. Can you elaborate a little bit on the other two steps which I am not at all familiar with? Ra, I am Ra. Imagine the body. Imagine the more dense aspects of the body. Proceed therefrom to the very finest knowledge of energy pathways which revolve and cause the body to be energized. Understand that all natural functions of the body have all aspects from dense to fine, and can be transmuted to what you may call sacramental. This is a brief investigation of the second area. To speak to the third, if you will, imagine the function of the magnet. The magnet has two poles. One reaches up. The other goes down. The function of the spirit is to integrate the upreaching yearning of the mind-body energy with the downpouring and streaming of infinite intelligence. This is a brief explication of the third area. Questioner, then would this training program involve specific things to do, specific instructions and exercises? Ra, I am Ra. We are not at this time incarnate among your peoples, thus, we can guide and attempt to specify, but we cannot, by example, show. This is a handicap. However, there should indeed be fairly specific exercises of mind, body, and spirit during the teach-learning process we offer. It is to be once more iterated that healing is but one distortion of the law of one. To reach an undistorted understanding of that law, it is not necessary to heal or to show any manifestation but only to exercise the discipline of understanding. We would ask that one or two more questions be the ending of this session. Questioner, my objective is primarily to discover more of the law of one, and it would be very helpful to discover the techniques of healing. I am aware of your problem with respect to free will. Can you state the law of one and the laws of healing to me? Ra, I am Ra. The law of one, though beyond the limitation of name, as you call vibratory sound complexes, may be approximated by stating that all things are one, that there is no polarity, no right or wrong, no disharmony, but only identity. All is one, and that one is love light, light love, the infinite creator. One of the primal distortions of the law of one is that of healing. Healing occurs when a mind-body-spirit complex realizes, deep within itself, the law of one, that is, that there is no disharmony, no imperfection, that all is complete and whole and perfect. Thus, the intelligent infinity within this mind-body-spirit complex reforms the illusion of body, mind, or spirit to a form congruent with the law of one. The healer acts as energizer or catalyst for this completely individual process. One item which may be of interest is that a healer asking to learn must take the distortion understood as responsibility for that ask receiving. This is an honor duty which must be carefully considered in free will before the asking. Questioner, I assume that we should continue tomorrow. Ra, I am Ra. Your assumption is correct unless you feel a certain question is necessary. This instrument is nurtured by approximately this length of work. Questioner, I have one more short question. Is this instrument capable of two of these sessions per day, or should we remain with one? Ra, I am Ra. This instrument is capable of two sessions a day. However, she must be encouraged to keep her bodily complex strong by the ingestion of your foodstuffs to an extent which exceeds this instrument's normal intake of your foodstuffs, this due to the physical material which we use to speak. The Law of One, Book I, Session 4. 93. Further, this instrument's activities must be monitored to prevent overactivity, for this activity is equivalent to a strenuous working day on the physical level. If these admonishments are considered, the two sessions would be possible. We do not wish to deplete this instrument. Questioner, thank you, Ra. Ra, I am Ra. I leave you in the love and the light of the one infinite intelligence which is the Creator. Go forth rejoicing in the power and the peace of the one. Adonai.
Okay, I figured that was a good place to stop. It's getting very good. I am going to try and put 4 to 5 sessions together as I go on putting these videos up online. I'll try not to narrate too much. Like, I can basically speak probably for an hour with every answer that Ra gives us with all these questions that are given to him. But I don't want to make these initial videos too long. I really want to get the information out there. So it's really interesting, you know, the backstory of Ra with the pyramids and how he came here, incarnated here as a wanderer himself from the sixth dimension. Because we have to remember, time doesn't exist within the sixth dimension. This is very confusing to a lot of us because we experience 3D reality with time. And when we leave the 3D and go into 4 and 5 and 6, time does not exist anymore. And it's a hard concept to understand when we're not in that dimension yet. We will be in about 90 million years. We'll join Ra, and Ra will be in the 7th and 8th dimension by then. We're getting through this material very fast because there is a lot of it, and I don't want to have hundreds and hundreds of videos. And I'm hoping that you guys are all just as fascinated with this material as I am. So let's move on to part 5. I will see you in the next video.